I got goosebumps. I got goosebumps. Does that mean I'm extra hyped for the show? It means the window's open right over there. No, it's going to be a fantastic show, and this is the Pro Wrestling Potluck. I am your host, Scotland Green, and this is the live weekly wrestling mixtape that I host every single week, every single Thursday, rain or shine. Got a heck of a show. You see up there, Rumble Ripoffs, our final week of Royal Rumble Ripoffs. It's been an adventure. And we got more tonight, including one we're going to vote on. I'm going to put the power in your hands, the viewer, the live viewer, the coveted live viewer. We got so much tonight. We got the Rumble Ripoffs, got some other great things. Also, the debut of Scotty's Positivity Corner. That's right. That's right. Last week we did the Current Events Corner, and I was thinking about bringing it back. And boy, the current events are a horror show, and there's no making hay of it. I'd rather do something fun and make jokes and not talk about how awful WWE as a company is and their leader, who they allowed to be a monster for decades. That's all. Well, there's no reason to break that down any further. It's a bad place, bad scene, and there's no reason to wallow in it. So let's do the positivity corner later in the show. Let's feel good. Let's lift each other up. Let's lift wrestling up. There's so many great things. And I know that we as Potluck, the Potluck community, look beyond World Wrestling Entertainment and their version of pro wrestling, which is run by abuse and awful things for decades. We got bigger horizons. So we'll talk about stuff tonight. We don't need to wallow in the negativity. There's that everywhere else you want to go. So that's all I'm going to say about that. We're going to have a fun show. We're going to have a great show, and I'm happy that that you're here watching. And if you're watching on YouTube, thank you. For some reason, I've been flatlining on YouTube. I had a couple great months growth and everything, and now I'm back to spinning around the toilet bowl. But that's okay. I am all about the live program. Of course. Cool Dude Food already getting me. All right. Yep, it's ready to go. I just checked with my producer, Sabrina, and she said, go. So, with that, let's go.
Earl. About 6 feet tall.
All right. This was sent in by the Suzanimal, Adam Suzanne, in the chat. Boo! Is there any greater heel in Potluck history than a cop? Is there anything worse? Cop wrestlers, get out of town. So we're starting off with the ultimate bad guys. The ultimate heels. Who could cheer for a cop? You'd have to be out of your mind. This is who we cheer for. Fire and Ice, baby. Scott Norton and Ice Train. Rest in peace, Ice Train. This was sent in by Suzanimal. Thank you for the cheers, Dave in Syracuse. Drinking Mexican Coca-Cola. A treat. A little treat for myself.
I tell you what, the opportunity might be knocking on the door for the State Patrol. Always, when you step into a WCW event, expect that.
Yeah, it's like a... Those guys are like proto super troopers. So much, and I know
these two talented State Patrollers are ready for fine ice. This morning on the pro. You
know, there's a way to do a cop gimmick and make it hilarious, but no one has the nuts to do a good, funny, subversive cop gimmick. Can you imagine?
TNT. It's going to be a great week, and we're kicking it off right here on WCW Pro, the power there of Ice Train.
Yeah, and you know, Chris, I'll tell you something. When you talk about Nitro, and we'll talk more about Nitro and about Saturday Night Tonight, but Booty Man coming off some type of injury, don't know where he's at, and him with Hulkamania and that big competition with Iron
Anderson,
the manager.
Oh, man. How did I forget about that? Cool Dude Food, Owen Straw, the man who makes the original music on the show, reminded me of the CMLL policeman who would dance. Thank you, Owen.
Attention, Owen Straw.
Yeah, all right, Sarge.
Look at the athleticism, the spring, and Buddy Lee Parker up and over, flat on his back.
Wouldn't that be, that would be a great heel turn for Orange Cassidy to be a cop. Oh my God. I think Brian just solved it. That's it. A lazy cop gimmick as a heel.
State Patrol, two pit bulls, but they're just dwarfed in here. Look at this.
Well, you talk about a heavy hitter. Scott Norton is a heavy hitter.
Scott Norton rules. He's on that list. I talk about this phenomenon a lot, and it's with a few different people. Two, Scott Norton is one of those wrestlers that I watch a match of his, and I go, oh my, I want to watch more Scott Norton. And not even necessarily, you know, looking up the best Scott Norton matches. I want to watch any. I feel the same way about, like, Too Cold Scorpio and Jinsei Shinsaki. They're just people that I don't see enough of, but I love them so much.
Impressive against this very impressive team of fire and ice, and they're double teaming, and that seems to be working, except right now. Oh, wait a minute. Again, they go for the clip.
Yeah.
Just like Gulliver's Travel.
Oh, yeah, number one Gunkle. I went to a Chikara show, and I got my picture taken with Officer Warren Barksdale. After starting a chant in the crowd, I was quite the crowd comedian. I would start the chant, "You can't search me. You can't search me." It was very, very good.
Shot clever there. But didn't have much of an effect on Norton. He's too big. These guys are better off staying on the leg. As big as Norton is, if he can't walk, he can't do much. Oh, he fell on him.
Buddy Lee Parker, at least he got Norton up, but then he just went flat on his back.
That was a good call, legend.
Whoa, he fell on him. Well, it's obvious there, but look at here. What they want to do is keep Norton from tagging the Ice Train. Stay on his feet. These guys are going to the upper body, and he's too big.
I can't believe these damn cops are getting so much offense. They're about to get double teamed right here.
Reversal here. What is Norton going to try?
There you go.
That takes so much.
These cops are about to plant some drugs on fire and ice. Here you go! Ice Train!
Look at the lariats there from the left and the right. And the scoop slam. And a second one from Ice Train. And Lieutenant James Earl now, he's at the mercy of Scott Norton as Buddy Lee Parker at the mercy of Ice Train.
Wow. Not that Tom Green with the background. And this is the perfect time for me to tell you, you gotta be following Not That Tom Green, WCW Deep Cuts, Tuesday night on Twitch. But you gotta follow him anyway, because he puts out these shorts that are so funny and informative. There you go. Fire and Ice winning. Oh, wow, they named one of the State Patrol after the guy who assassinated MLK. Wow. Wrestling has always not been the best.
Well, Sergeant Buddy Lee Parker managed to save his neck. No thanks to Ice Train, but look at the power of Scott Norton here. Picked up both men by their heads, suplexed them backwards. Here's the coup de grace for Lieutenant James Earl. Shoulder breaker by Scott Norton. Ice Train. The legal man comes down, squashes him like a grape. Fire and ice. Definitely a man.
Fire and ice.
So much more to come here on WCW Pro on TBS this morning, including an interview up close and personal.
I always love the WCW thing where they show the winner's entrance again at the end. I never got why, but I like it. Nice seeing the boys happy.
Slim Jim. Man, you seen the size of Harlem Heat lately?
They're huge, man.
What is this?
I know. I'll tell you. I'm sick of it.
Oh, we got a little extra.
Yeah.
What did Luger say?
I'll tell you. Nobody else. All right.
What in the world?
What did he say? You and me joined the Shake Your Booty Tour, huh?
Hey, what's wrong? What's your side?
We know how to get the dirt. Call 1-900.
God damn, that rules. Me and Gene being a creep. Disco Inferno being a creep. Hey, there he is.
Come on.
The biggest free agent on planet Earth. Last week, Necro Eric broke the news. Uh-oh. Oh, there's the dead body of Crush. Wait, I can explain. I can explain the dead body of Crush. if you don't remember, a week or two ago, we watched a Bollywood film called Khiladiyon Ka Khiladi. I think that's the name of it. And Undertaker was in it. Brian Lee, my favorite Undertaker, was in it, and he killed Crush, and we watched that clip. It was great. And I found the whole movie, and I was like, wait, there's probably more than just that one 10-minute fight that a couple other people have found. Yeah, there's more. There's Crush dead in the back of a van. All right, let's get back to it. The video of Undertaker versus Crush on YouTube is the highest amount of viewers anything featuring me did. I have like one match that I put up that doesn't have me on it, and it did 35,000 views, of course. But the watching the Undertaker versus Crush is the best video I have. Beating even the John Watanabe interview, I think. But I don't think the John Watanabe interview is representative of me and the show in quite the same way. And there goes Crush, rolling away.
Ma, Ma, mujhe maaf kar do, Ma. Ma, meri raksha karo, Ma.
There he is asking God for forgiveness.
Oh, Ajay.
For disposing of Crush's body. Heel Crush, one of my favorite wrestling characters as a boy. How was work today? Did you drop any wrestlers into the river?
Jane, tumhe meri is badsurat duniya ko khoobsurat banana hai, Jane. I love you, Jane.
Bollywood Machio is our first possible title. Brian is killing it today already. He was killing it in the damn pre-show, making me laugh while I was dotting my eyes. Oh, the cops. Looks like State Patrol have found Crush. He's washed up.
Wait a minute.
All right. Maybe we'll be checking back in with the movie. Yeah, he got he's got that good makeup. He had that old Sting makeup from back in the day. All right, this is our next match, and it is our first Royal Rumble ripoff of the night. This is from DDT. This is from DDT, and little background, this is the Aja Kong Rumble. Every person in this Rumble is wearing Aja Kong makeup and doing Aja Kong tributes. And we'll see how this goes. I found out that this existed, searched all over for it, could not find it on any of my bootleg sites, finally found it on a porno site, which is kind of scary, and I'm hoping it's not for any reason that shows up in this match, but I had to go get nefarious downloaders that would let me download off of sketch porno sites. So that's how I found this match. This was on a porno site. Well, see, I don't know if it's specifically this match, because I had to get the whole show. It's an entire three-hour DDT show. So, yeah. That's my yeah, it's my story, and I'm sticking to it. It's Ethan Page! It's Karate Man himself! Very specific fetish is going into our possible titles. I feel like a lot of our titles have been sexual lately. All right. The rumble is on. Now, excuse me if I don't know who everyone is. I'm going to pull up the match on Cage Match, see if maybe they give you the order or something. This is from, oh god, I want to say 2018, but I might be wrong. It is from 2018, it's from March 2018. Saki Akai produced this whole show. She won this afro that she wears to give her powers to run the show, I think is the little background that I got. We saw this guy, I think his name is Great Matsuno, right?
Yeah.
So Antonio Honda was the first person out, and then Ethan Page. This is Gorgeous Matsuno, who we saw wrestle the Giant Panda. Love this guy. This Aja Kong Rumble is on. He's having no effect on All Ego Kong. All right, who's coming up next? Yeah, that says it all. Who we saw wrestle the Giant Panda. I can say that. All right, so this is Harashima. Everybody's got their little Aja Kong office trash can. The bucket. Oh, the fist. He's just gonna keep doing the spinning back fist till it hits somebody. Andrew Heelan, you absolutely should dress this Aja Kong. Andrew Kong. I bet Aja Kong's got a supplier and they were very happy to get 8 or 10 trash cans. So I think our boy Gorgeous Matsuno is has to hit the showers. Next up, time for your next competitor in this Aja Kong Rumble. Oh wait, this is not the order that... Oh boy. Now I'm not sure. So that was Takagi that was out earlier. And I mistakenly called him... Okay, this is into... See, God dog it. Don't listen to me. Don't listen to me. That's my advice. I am both the person showing you the cool thing and the person asking you, what is this? Don't listen to me is a good title. Yeah, he looks like he's got clown makeup. I want to learn Japanese just so I can get these jokes. You said it, number one gunkle. I experience DDT. I'm not sure I know what is happening to me while I'm watching. Takagi taking one. Paige blocks it. Nipple stuff. All right, Antonio Honda has eliminated Ethan Page. There he is. Now they're telling you who people are. Wow. Harashima. Sip of water. Little shoot water.
それは私も出はいます。あ、でも怖い、怖いですよ。あ、アジャコンクを見たら震え上がるという、やっぱり怖い。夢に出てくるわ。これは怖い。あ、怖い、怖い。あ、これ怖い。いやいや、あっちも大概だよ。原島選手、妖怪好きですからね。あ、裏剣が、打ち込めない。あ、でも1人だけオープンフィーカーも。
He's trying for the spinning back fist. He's turning it into a dance, a beautiful dance. He's got double spinning back fist. I am gonna keep doing this, and if you get in the way. This is a Super Sasadango Machine, I think. I could be wrong. Very Simpsons offense. If only I could remember the exact quote, I would have said it right there. Oh no, cutting the hair! This is ridiculous. God damn, I wish I could speak Japanese. You know this is hilarious. You know Aja Kong is being hilarious. Time for another entrant. I feel like they weren't playing the music for everyone before, and now they are. Hey, it's Maki Ito! Look, this is a different version of Maki Ito. They're having a roar off. Oh my god. That might be our thumbnail. It's coming from this. It's Harashima's gone. The roar of Maki Ito. I love how this group, they're not fighting right now. They're all just recovering. Maki Ito digging in the trash can. They're all fighting over bananas. This is like Mardi Gras. Reliable arbiter in the house. The sad clown face is so great. So all these clowns are having fun. Yeah, I get that. Healing. Well, all these pretenders are suddenly shaking in their boots when the real deal. Aja Kong. It really is, Suzanne. This is like when the person being impersonated on SNL shows up. Yeah, this is like Hillary Clinton. Oh man, that's great. Oh, everybody gets a bucket to the head. Bucket to the head. Shout out to Buckethead. No, he's gone. Everybody's gone now. Super Sasadango, Antonio Honda, Sanshiro Takagi. Today I became the first person to compare Aja Kong to Hillary Clinton. Herstory. I never knew that there was a blonde Maki Ito era. Shout out to Buckethead. Could be a fun title. Might as well add it. Ooh. Brain Buster Maki Ito is out. Oh my god. Makoto. Oishi. Oh, spinning back fist. Three in a row have no effect on Aja Kong, but a big effect on his hand.
So,
So these are the final two competitors in this Aja Kong Rumble, our first Rumble ripoff of the night. He keeps blocking. Oh my god. Oh, can on the head, spinning back fist. Steps on the chest. Your winner of the Aja Kong Rumble. Aja Kong, as it should be. Aja Kong, getting everybody in there. There are so many Rumble ripoffs. We'll be doing this next year. So this announcer was giving her a hard time before the show, before I edited that out, because there's a couple minutes of them just talking. Oh yeah, we'll be doing it. If there's no Rumble next year, this will be the Rumble. We'll have the 4 weeks of it. Kong's got him by the hair. There you go. Kong takes out everybody. Reliable Arbiter, thanks for the cheers.
Bottom wrist lock, lateral drop into a head scissors by Wrestling 2. Tenru trapped in that head scissors now.
All right. That was fun. Loving these Rumble ripoffs. Different takes. The Mexican Coke. There it is. It's the Undertaker himself.
Let's go.
Arriving by plane. Working for this Maya character. And this settles it. This is my favorite Undertaker thing in the history of the Undertaker character. Undertaker in this movie is the best.
I'll get ready.
I'll get ready, says the Undertaker. All right. Not time for this yet. We got something else. What do we have? All right, today in wrestling history, we have Lou Thesz versus Vern Gagne in a best 2 out of 3 falls match. Happened January 25th, 1952. Now, we're not going to watch that because it's 45 minutes long. So instead, We're going to watch this. This also happened on January 25th. Cactus Jack, Mr. Hughes, and Vinnie Vegas were a trio. Mr. Hughes, that's my Vern Gagne.
And from Nevada, weighing 300 pounds, Vinny Vegas.
Yeah, I know there's someone really mad that I didn't play a 45-minute Luthez match from 1952. I'm going to get some thumbs downs on my YouTube version of this. And who's fighting this wonderful trio of Mr. Hughes, Vinny Vegas, and Cactus Jack? Well, of course, it's the All-American Ron Simmons, Babyface Abdullah the Butcher, and Big Josh. When I saw that this, because I like to see what happened, what can I show that happened on this day? And when I saw that this happened, I was like, well, I need an excuse to watch this. Abdullah the Butcher, Babyface.
At 9 o'clock. Abdullah the Butcher.
Yeah, somehow wear the same clothes.
And there you see Vinny Vegas. Almost
Big Josh, Lumberjack Doink, as Dr. Liam put it. Now, you got to follow, I'll take this time right now and tell you, you got to follow Dr. Liam on Instagram. Crimson Mask Replica. One of the best accounts, every day posting gems
we saw Vinny Vegas for the first time
of all kinds. Every day is a different gimmick over on Crimson Mask Replica. Yeah, they should have done something to look like a team.
Sunday, February the 9th. Abdullah the Butcher, a very unlikely tag team partner for Ron Simmons and Big Josh.
Take him to the big and tall shop. I think that might be a title, possible title. Just take him to the big and tall shop. That's going. That's going in there. It's going on the list. We got five good ones right now.
Fans, will remind you that next week here on WCW, we'll have more main events announced for Super Brawl 2 exclusively on pay-per-view. Saturday, February 29th. As a matter
the weirdest team. They have nothing in common.
Go on sale this Monday in Milwaukee at the Mecca Box Office and all Ticketmaster outlets.
Cactus Jack and with two suited dudes.
By calling 414-276-4545.
All right, Big Josh and Cactus lock up. Center of the ring.
Big Josh.
Number one Gunkle says, this is close to my favorite WCW trio. Abdullah, Norman the Lunatic, and Mike Rotundo. I can't believe that's a group.
Good fireman carry takeover by Big Josh. Good move. He didn't learn that move in Oregon. Great martial arts move there from the Orient. Again, those logger boots caught Cactus. And now Josh.
Nice. Big Josh can go, folks.
Single leg pickup and a long roll. And
ooh.
You
know, I don't know. I don't know if this is Battle Bowl or if this is just bad booking. But bad booking in the sense that, you know, it don't make sense that they're a team, but I love it. That's one of the only ones I watch, the Doink Dark Side of the Ring. I've said this before. I would love to watch more Dark Side of the Ring. It's too sad. It's too sad. I can't do it. The world is sad enough. I can't take it. It's just a random six-man tag. There you go. And I believe not that Tom Green. He is my source. He's the WCW plug, as the kids say. I love Fever Dream booking. Yep. It really is my favorite thing to be like, these guys?
Simmons side headlock, Vinny Vegas. Trying to find a formula to get Simmons off his feet.
Yeah, exactly. You're not gonna, you couldn't pay me to watch the Benoit episode. It's like, yeah, it's fucking terrible. I know. I don't need a documentary to tell me it's awful.
The former Kansas State defensive lineman. Just about as
Mr. Hughes.
Anyone you'll ever come across. Two former great footballers in there.
Trainer. Ooh, goddamn, look at that. Ron Simmons rules.
A normal man would have been pinned right there. But Hughes is certainly not normal. What a power slam. That man, 375. Great explosion by Simmons.
I tried watching Resurrection of Jake, and it felt like, no offense to anybody, but I tried watching it, and it felt like a DDP yoga infomercial. And I had to stop.
Simmons retaliates with some right hands, but Cactus breaks the eyes to reaffirm his advantage. Irish whip. And Cactus taking Simmons straight down. He may have him here, and Abdullah interrupts the kick.
Ooh, Abdullah and Cactus, old foes.
I'm not so sure Abdullah is as much a partner to Simmons and Josh as he is an enemy to Cactus Jack.
Ooh, elbow. Stops with the back elbow. Ron Simmons is cooking.
So Cactus Jack that he can execute that move as well. Cactus Jack tagging in Mr. Hughes. And Simmons.
So everybody in this match went to WWF except Abdullah the Butcher, right? Wow, okay, that's good. Putting us in the time frame. Ron is the world champ 10 months from now. Yeah, I think I would like DDP yoga. But Billy Jack's not in this match. We got Vinny Vegas, Cactus, and Mr. Hughes. Mr. Hughes gets the pin. When the hell does that happen? Mr. Hughes makes one of the best faces in wrestling. Sure, he can only make one face, but it's great. Big Josh is doink. Big Josh is face paintless doink.
Fighting in the locker room area. What a feud that is. It's got to be settled inside a steel cage.
Oh my God.
From Ron Simmons.
Please find that.
And right here, you saw the double team. Josh caught him from a 300 pounder and a 375.
I always forget about that, Dr. Liam, and for a while I just didn't even know.
And when we come back, we'll take a look.
All right, what's next?
And see the rookie Marcus Bagwell in action.
Everybody remembers Hollywood's giant.
Now, this was sent in by Andrew Heelan,
which wreaked havoc and caused massive destruction. Now, the competitors here in the World Wrestling Federation are shaking with fear because, like Hollywood's giant gorilla,
this guy needs a haircut.
And destructive King Kong.
Hey, yo, dude. We'll be making they let you on TV with a haircut like that. You gotta do a little trim, my man. Little.
However, we don't think that he is 80 feet tall.
All right, back to Bollywood.
Kamal ka khel hai, kamal ka khel hai. Kaisa lagta hoga aapko? मैं तो नया नया हूँ, मुझे तो इतना मालूम नहीं, लेकिन मुझे बहुत डर लगता है।
डर? कैसा डर?
मौत का? मान गया वैसे तुम्हें। अरे क्या क्या वफादारी है मैडम माया के साथ?
Is he going to massage the Undertaker?
कुर्बानी दे रहा आज?
कुर्बानी? मतलब?
आज तुम हारने वाले हो ना?
I really wish it had subtitles.
मैं?
हाँ वो नीचे बात कर रहे थे कि मैडम माया और किंगडम।
Yeah, just put your hair in front of your face. We'll put all the lines in.
यही डी चल रही थी उनकी।
क्या बक रहे हो?
He's moving the hair out of the Undertaker's face.
I'm sorry, I'm...
If that's Dennis Knight, then Dennis Knight's my favorite Undertaker. We should get goddamn Midian on the show.
Impossible.
I need guests. Haven't had a guest this year. I got burned. By Steamboat Willie. I'm not mentioning him again until he's on the show.
The
Hawks.
Kamini, ab main bataunga.
Madam Maya.
Hi.
Maya.
अब ये मत कहना किंग डॉन कि तुम्हारा फाइटर आज लड़ने के लिए तैयार नहीं है.
मेरा फाइटर तो लड़ने के लिए इतना उतावला है कि मैं बैट डबल कर रहा हूँ. $10 million.
लगता है आज तुम यहाँ कंगाल होने के इरादे से आए हो.
Midian was on acid when they sacrificed Stephanie on Raw. That's awesome. We definitely got to get him on the show. Play wrestler or drug or whatever.
Very good. Attention, ladies and gentlemen.
So I think this guy's name is King Don.
अब सनसनी खेज हो चुका है क्योंकि खेल के इतिहास में पहली बार इतनी बड़ी बाजी लगाई जा रही है. मैडम माया और किंग डॉन आज की रात बाजी लगा चुके हैं $10 million.
That's Maya.
आज किंग डॉन में इतनी हिम्मत कहां से आ गई?
Maya and King Don are old rivals, I believe. This is me trying to make sense of a Bollywood film through clips.
Tonight there might be no fight!
Oh, what? Look at this group! There is dancing in this movie. We don't have any of it on the show. Oh, there he is. The man who killed Crush. Undertaker 2.0. So, in editing this and finding these clips that featured the Undertaker and the dead body of Crush, I did see that there were music and dancing in this, but no music and dancing with The Undertaker, unfortunately, so it's not included. But this movie looks like a fucking thrill. It looks great. Okay. Now, if you remember, last week we watched K-Krush and his partner Backstreet, whatever, Sunny Stone, let's say. And I fell in love with the American pro wrestling. And I have so much more. And I found a bunch immediately after the show last week. And Dr. Liam sent me some. So we're going to be checking out American Pro for a while, and who knows, there might be a Sunday or a Saturday afternoon or night that we watch a full episode, because I found some of that too. But here we go, back to American Pro.
Champion, rough Rusty Riddle. Rusty, I know you.
Now let's not sleep on who this is. This is, we heard the name last show, Rough Rusty Riddle. Now let's hear from Rough Rusty Riddle.
Ladies, Dan Paris at ringside with former United States heavyweight champion, Rough Rusty Riddle. Rusty, I know you've got a very special challenge on your mind.
Yeah, I've already had the United States heavyweight belt. I guess I'll go for the next notch down. There's so much pus going back here.
You've seen
ridiculous.
Fake Undertaker. Now here's fake Brian Lee.
Just a bunch of you know what, and I'm not going to do it. And I've got news for Jay Eagle and everybody else back there. I don't want no belts. I'll take what belts I want when I want, but I'm going to take the whole federation because I got a little thing going no one knows about. And here next month, you're going to find out, Mr. Jay Eagle, your politics and your belts.
Rusty Riddle, in other words...
Sound is off on this. I hope it's not off on the match.
Basically, you've got a mastermind plan, but later on in this hour, you're making a challenge to TV champion Backstreet Sonny Stone.
Sonny Stone's a good wrestler. We
That's already back to normal. Okay.
Way back. Back wave. Trust me, I've run with this guy forever. Sonny Stone, I have a lot of
This guy's high.
For,
I can tell. Look in his eyes. He is high.
Back to the matter. I'm going to take your belt, okay? And then I'm going to take it back to Jay on time where he can stick it.
Rusty Riddle, looking forward to a TV title match later on this hour. Ladies and gentlemen, back to the commentators.
He won't even leave his fanny pack backstage with the boys because he knows it stinks like pot. The American sad ass. Thank you, number one gunkle. Fake Brian Lee. Brian Lee 2.0 is stoned to the fucking bone.
In the name of Satan, the ruler of the earth, the king of the world,
weighing 290 pounds,
their infernal power upon
from
me.
Parts
Only what is this little
unknown.
Speech?
And come forth from the
purple haze.
Purple haze. Well, that's what was in fake Brian Lee's fanny pack.
I have taken thy name as part of myself. I live
Ask
as a beast of the field,
mic.
Rejoicing in the fleshly life. I favor the just.
You hear the ring announcer saying, he wants my
By
mic.
All the gods of the pit, I command.
Yes, this is from the year 2100. We have to look forward to this.
Weighing 225 pounds from Motown, K-Krush.
Here you go, from Motown, baby.
Yeah, you know what? What? Throw your hands up, throw your hands up. What? Yeah, introducing the K-Krush down, punk master. Breaking white knuckleheads off because I have to. Had a rough ride.
Breaking white knuckleheads off because I have to. Hell yeah. As a white knucklehead, I say, break me off, sir. Hootie hoo! Dude, Ron Killings rules. It says Y2K on his ass. Crush you, the man. Hell yeah. Look at Purple Haze! He looks like the Phantom!
I'll make a prediction right now. K-Krush will go to
the wall. Yeah, Suzanne already said it. Bill Zane! Oh, I know who's under that. I know who's under that mask. Look at that mask! This is like, is that like Carl Winslow? This is like a sitcom wrestling outfit. Like, the dad from Alf has to be a wrestler because the wrestler got sick because Alf poisoned him. Oh, Alf. I like how there's more than one Purple Haze in wrestling.
Irish whip across, reversed by Purple Haze. Goes for hip toss block.
Ooh!
Bill White, I tell you what, this Purple Haze is a strange individual indeed.
Most definitely strange.
Snapmare takeover into the rear chin.
Slowing it down.
Referee in to see if it's a choke. I've never seen anything like that.
Referee Ferguson checking it out.
Chance Williams, I tell you what, he is a bizarre individual. I'll tell you one thing about Jeff G. Bailey. I'm about scared to set at ringside with him.
Can you imagine? That would be so awesome. There would be no bigger pop than Micro Man playing Alf in the cosplay wrestling.
People love me. I'm the people's favorite.
Ooh, countered, but I guess Truth ain't selling it.
Tremendous amount of moves there as Purple Haze caught him and put him on his back. Scoop slam coming up. It just plants him up on that top rope. Keep your eye on Crush.
He is a powerful man.
Crush making his way up to that second rope.
He's not really going to do this.
Oh, my God. Look at that second rope. The strength of K-Crush. You said it. He is trying way too hard. No wonder this dude's a fucking star. He's working hard in this.
Jeff G, is that what you get for being in the cotton fields?
I'm not really sure about
and he's
that.
Still going. Yeah. Still going strong. Number one merch seller.
I don't know about all this, but I can tell you this.
Deserves it.
Jeff G. Bailey and Bill White, I'm sitting in the middle.
When we have
our
comedy episode where we salute the comedy heroes in wrestling, our Truth is up there, and he can actually wrestle. He ain't just like a clown.
And a Purple Haze with a nerve hold here.
Oh, Purple Haze with a nerve hold. Who's surprised?
Bill White, I can tell you this. I'm not scared of Jeff G. Bailey, but I can tell you this. He's got some thugs that follow him around that can do the damage. I promise you that.
He's got some people that follow him around, all right?
Yeah, there's pictures of him in, like, the early 90s, 80s, where he's, like, with Easy E, and he's got a picture with Tupac. He's, like, a backup dancer. The dude has led a life.
Crush finding himself looking up the lights here. There's a big hammer fist.
Oh, down. Another. Now he's gripping his stomach.
Back to the old school Bill White. I hadn't seen that since the old Assassins.
Well, this seems to be working. K-Crush looks to be on.
Thank you, Andrew.
He's really gripping on those
abs. Purple Haze, a strange individual.
Purple Haze looks like a fucking shy guy.
Knee to the midsection off the far row.
There you go.
What an athlete this guy is.
I don't know who's playing Purple Haze. Yeah, the audio mix is real bad, even for potluck standards. Three, there you go. Your winner, Rap Master, K-Crush. Crush getting some booze. Well, they are in South Carolina. Guy holding the baby. Hell yeah. Let's bring our baby to the wrestling show.
Got him up on his shoulder. Running power slam. And K-Crush just powders to the outside. Fans, let's get away from this situation here. We'll be back right after this commercial timeout.
K-Crush rules.
Union, South Carolina. Be on the lookout because American Pro Wrestling is coming to the National Guard Armory on Saturday.
We'll be there.
May 22nd. At
May 22nd, 2100.
A double main event in tag team action. The Beach Blondes take on Rapmaster K-Crush and Backstreet Sunny.
So this is right around the same period that we watched last week.
Nature Boy, Buddy Landell in Union, South Carolina. Hardcore Hitman Hunter will face Big
Hardcore Hitman Hunter. I like
Billy
to call
Bad
him Triple H.
With the Big Mac truck. All sorts of great action. All the top American pro wrestling stars will be there. Lots of excitement for the whole family. And advance tickets are now on sale at Smith.
Other exciting matches for episode title. It might do me good.
Second, fans, be sure to come to the National Guard Armory, because after that night, Union will never be the same. An all-points bulletin has been put out in Gaffney, South Carolina. Oh. American Pro Wrestling.
All-points bulletin. What? Has Rough Rusty Riddle been released from prison?
8:00 p.m. bell time. In a wild six-man tag team main event, the Beach Blondes and the Mack Truck square off with Chief J. Eagle, Renegade Johnny Eagle, and Backstreet Sonny Stone. Also, Black Jack Dalton, one-on-one.
Big Hammer. There's someone's name. Big Hammer.
And Hunter squares off against Big Hammer.
Big Hammer
comes to Gaffney to take on Maverick Terry Austin. All this and more, lots of excitement. American Pro Wrestling comes to town. Bring the whole family. And don't forget to pick up your advance tickets at Pick a Flick and save $1 off the price. That's Saturday night, May 15th, Gaffney, National Guard Armory, bell time, 8 o'clock p.m. Don't miss it, fans. Be
Donnie
there.
Gilbert is the Purple Haze, according to Dr. Liam. We're going to start watching full episodes of this show.
Ladies and gentlemen, it's a walkover. Aaj raat fight hogi hi nahi.
Checking back in with Khiladiyon Ka Khiladi.
I know that you will be very upset. But no one will cry here.
Now, did I have a successful video on YouTube that had Bollywood, and so now I'm looking for the next Bollywood clip? Yes. Yes. Goddamn, Bollywood Clue would rule. King Don. All right. You wanted to see The Undertaker in action, folks. King Don! There you go, Maya.
Madam Maya. शायद तुम मेरे जज्बात की ताकत को नहीं जानती जय माता दी डैन
ओह शिट यस अंडरटेकर चोक स्लैम किप अप बाय योर बॉय या ही'स गॉट सम फ्लाई एडिडास. Undertaker doing what I do when I crush up treats to put on the cat's food. Ooh, the kicks. I forgot this guy's name, but he's a big star, I believe. I wish Brian Lee just continued to be the Undertaker in other places. Undertaker catching him, slamming his face into the ground. Look at this. Spinning him around, this sort of giant swing. Whoa, around and around. He's flying.
Come on, Akshay. Get up.
Oof. He's bleeding. There's blood. King Don putting on his gloves. Ooh! Taker's got him by the head. Yeah, we're back to the video game music. Does a forward roll into the wall. Ooh, Taker helps him out. Shows him the wall yet again. It's the wall, brother. Ooh, big chop. The fans have one motion like a Street Fighter background. Love it. This dude's taking bumps on the silk. Undertaker's having his way with this young man. Up the stairs.
No.
Whoa. Fist to the face. Three in a row. Catches the foot. Ooh! Stairs bump. That's worse than a Samoa Joe stair bump. I could not love this more. Ooh, Undertaker over the stairs. There's hope in Maya's eyes. Ooh, your boy gets a kickoff. Taker's down. Taker's down. He sits up. With the tie on his face. Oh my God, he's gonna pull a New Jack. New Jack! From the top. Oh God, this is great bumper material. Thank you. I need to make new bumpers. Retire some old ones. Sad to say. Oof. Oh, here come the damn cops to ruin everything. Ruin this good time. Cops! Cops are here! God damn, this Undertaker rules. Supposed to be in New York. Alright, we're not watching this yet.
Path to finish it.
All right. I meant to start the show with this. I got Chinese food before the show. A little information, a little background on me. And this is my fortune cookie. And before, it was my fortune from the cookie. Before I ate the cookie, I said to myself, I said, this fortune will apply to the show. This is the show's fortune. And it says, old friends, old wines, and old gold are the best. I don't know what that means, but I'm drinking Mexican Coke, baby! All right. So now I put the power in your hands, folks. I alluded to this the past couple weeks. In finding these Rumble ripoffs, some of them I knew might not make it to YouTube. And so I would do a little test upload just to see if they would work. And, you know, some got shut down, some didn't. The ones that didn't, we watched. And there's a couple that got shut down that I just want to watch. And, yeah, I hope the power goes to your heads. So here's what I'm saying. I have a Rumble that's about 20, let's say 20 minutes long. And I have a match that was submitted by two different people. So it means we will watch it. We might not watch it this week. But I'm going to let you vote. Live viewers, vote on if we should watch this Rumble or if we should just let it go and, you know, worry about our YouTube brethren. So let me get that vote. All right. Poll should be going. Poll should be going. Do you see it? Let it go. Rumble. I will always pick the Rumble. YouTubers can learn to watch live. That's what I say too. I don't want to affect the vote too much. But YouTubers, goddamn, I want you to watch live. I think you would love it. If you love the show later, you would really love it live. Being in the chat or even just lurking, I'm sure is fun. All right, are people voting? There is a poll. Ooh, yes. Yes has 7 votes. No has 1 vote. Looks like we're going to do it. We're going to do it. Which means the match that I have, I'm going to move to the next week or whatever. But it will be played. Cuz that's the rule here. Yes wins with 8 votes. Thanks for voting, everybody. Vote or die in the words of P. Diddy, a criminal. So here's... What was I going to say? Oh, God. Okay, well, we're going to watch it. We're going to do it. Thank you so much for voting. Is there anything else? Oh, yeah. If you're watching, please subscribe. on everything. Please subscribe. I noticed something. You know, I watch other people's videos, YouTubes and whatnot. I like to see what other people do. And I watched a video where a guy said, subscribe, please. And it was so strange because there's such a difference in please subscribe and subscribe, please. Subscribe, please sounds like when you hold the door open for somebody and you're like, you're welcome. You know, I don't know. There's a different vibe to subscribe, please. Yes. And you know my feelings on P. Diddy. I have booed a video. I went to a Raw before and have booed a video of Diddy until I was hoarse. So there you go. All right, we'll be right back with this Rumble ripoff. All right, we got a few things left. We're ending with a Rumble, so we're going over. I apologize to anybody who's looking to watch Babylon 5. We'll be going over a bit tonight. And real quick, you know, I talked about it. And, you know, a lot of horrible things in wrestling, but let's get positive, folks. In the chat, what's something positive? This is Scotty's Positivity Corner. I took the hot takes and gave them a break. Current event corner, let's cool it. Everybody else can talk about their current events. Let's be positive. What's some positive stuff? I got some good answers from Instagram. What in wrestling is making you smile right now? I'd like to know. I'd like to know. Hey, some may say, is this a cry for help? Scotty's Positivity Corner, is this a cry for help? And I would say, I ain't crying. let's see, what do people say? Got some good answers. Joshi Supremacy, that was from Elliot, who's in the chat right now. Crimson Mask Replica, the sheer amount of great wrestling available, and Potluck on Thursdays, which made me smile. Mustafa Ali's run right now, that's fucking great. That's exciting to see him hit the ground running and just have so much planned and not just be like, well, I hope TNA picks me up. I'm going to chill. You know, he's ready to work and ready to rumble. Not that Tom Green says Nyla Rose is killing it on Ring of Honor. If she was doing that on AEW TV right now, it'd be such a big deal. I haven't watched Ring of Honor, so I need to check in on that. I need to check in on Ring of Honor in general, because I do miss stuff from it. And it seems like that's where some people's development is happening right now. That's the thing that I'm... the Dalton Castle Johnny TV feud is good. That's what people are saying. Dr. Liam says, Timeless Tony and Mariah May together are amazing. RJ City and Mariah May was great too. Yep, another vote for Tony Storm. I got one in Instagram too. She can't miss. I said this on Instagram. I think I said this in my group chat. Tony Storm is the most consistently funny promos going today, maybe ever. Nobody gets me worse or better, you know? I laugh hard. That's what I'm saying. Sartori says, I'm excited for the next generation of New Japan Pro Wrestling. Shota Umino and Ren Narita main evented Kurik and Hall. Yeah, that's something I noticed when I watched the G1 is like, you know, it sucks that Okada's leaving, but it really was like kind of a logjam up top and unchanging. And now they're going to have to do something, you know? New Japan is a company, from what I know, that they're part of their story is how the company is doing, you know, and who steps up and who saves the company. And that's something that they actually talk about on the show. And I think that's going to happen. I think somebody is going to step up. I think we're going to see some of these people that have come back in the past couple of years from excursions really look for that top spot. Brian says, I like that OVW hired Mickie James. I think any wrestler there can learn from her. A damn legend. Mickie James, freaking legend. Back when WWF women's wrestling was not that hot and was terrible, she was great. And she's somebody that you can tell fought for wrestling, fought for good wrestling. Yoda Tsuji's great. Yeah. Yeah, Mickey's a damn Hall of Famer. She's so rad. Okay. Is there anything else? Wrestle Kingdom this year felt like a lots of people had moved a few spots up on the card and should absolutely be there. It's very cool. Yeah. That was my problem with New Japan, is it felt unchanging. And it you know, it sucks. Like, they should be organically changing, but sometimes some change happens because you have to, because something happens to make the change. Yeah, bright future. I don't know if this fits the theme, but I hope Nick Nemeth calls the zigzag the knickknack. I like that Nick Nemeth is working a lot. I'm excited for his future. All right, I think that's it for these positive takes, and I appreciate it. I'm going to echo what Dr. Liam said. I am very happy at just the amount of wrestling and the amount that's available to watch, not even current stuff. Like, we can go back, like, goddamn, I fell in love with American Pro Wrestling, a company I've never even heard of. And that's what I like about it. The pro wrestling bucket is so deep. All right. I will be right back. I felt like there was something else I wanted to talk about. In February, next week, we got a gimmick episode. That's right. Next freaking week, we got a gimmick episode, an idea that Andrew Heelan gave me. And it's going to be, the gimmick is the middle of winter. That's right. We're going to be in the smack dab middle of winter next week. And so send me submissions, whatever that means to you. Dig deep, please. And I already got some submissions, but and there's things that I can just look for myself and everything. But send them on over, whatever the middle of winter means to you. And I'm thinking about having people vote on the next gimmick episodes. Because I have a few options, and you know me, I have a hard time making decisions. And so I think that's going to be something the subscribers will vote on. The tier of subscribers will help pick future gimmick episodes. And the last thing, I'm going to take a couple things off this show. Don't worry, we're going close to the end. I put this out to Instagram people, what old segment should come back, and Sartori said Rad to Sad. It's been a while since we ranked things from Rad to Sad, and then I got an idea from Gotch Style Bong Rips, another great Instagram follow, where he said we could rank catchphrases. And I think that's a great idea, because we can dig deep on that. Because it's not going to be something like the John Hennigan names where we list every single thing. Some just won't make the list. But I think I might take calls on that. And calls are preferred over chat as far as what makes the list. Because the chat's going to be too many to read and to do. So we're going to do that. And that's that. I'll be right back. I got to take some things off this list. See ya in a second. Mm-hmm. Another today in history, my God. It's unprecedented that we've looked back twice on one show. 25 years ago today.
World Championship Wrestling. I've set up camp back in the locker room area with this man, Bret the Hitman Hart. And as you heard earlier on, the Nature Boy Ric Flair, as president of WCW, announcing a mandatory.
Wow, number one Gunkle, where are you? It's 4 a.m. there? Thanks for watching. Good golly. A salute to number one Gunkle.
However, in a non-title bout, you've got Booker T. You've got a full plate here, I must say.
You know, I don't know what Ric Flair's problem is, you know. You know, I've always been a jam-up guy. I've always been a guy that's never
done anything, Scotland. One day
anybody,
I'll go.
Anytime, anywhere. Now, Ric Flair, you know, this is a case of a guy that's carrying around a grudge. He's had a grudge against me since I've come here, and, you know, that's fine. He wants to throw me in a ring tonight with Booker T. Who is Booker T? Who is this guy to even have a match with me, let alone a non-title match, because he's a loser. He's not going to get a title shot. You can forget about that.
Well, he is not a loser. You know that,
Brett. He's a loser. Now, Booker T, I want to ask you a question. Have you got the guts to step in the ring with the Excellence of Execution tonight? Do you know that your life is on the line? Your career is on the line? All the little kids at home, they're going to watch me tear you up and break you in little pieces. Is that what you want? I'm sure that's what Ric Flair wants.
Well, I'll tell you one thing about Booker T. This man has held numerous titles in World Championship Wrestling, and there's a guy that we would be deserving of a chance at your United States title.
Let me tell you about who deserves a shot at the United States Heavyweight
Champion. Let's
hear it. I'm the champion. I ought to know. You know, I've been sizing up guys since I came to the WCW. And I think the one guy that stands out the most, the guy that I think has earned a title shot, El Dandy, I think you're a heck of a wrestler. You're a great technician in the ring, and you're a jam-up guy. Whoa. I don't see any reason.
Wait a minute. El Dandy has been wrestling in the cruiserweight division here. Please.
He's a great wrestler.
He's a great wrestler, but my goodness sakes, it's 50 pounds difference.
Who are you to doubt El Dandy? Because this guy's a serious professional.
Well, let's talk about some serious contenders.
How about hypnosis? Let's get thrown.
Psychosis?
Whatever. He's a great wrestler. You know, you
how
can
about
say
hypnosis?
What you want. You can try to tear these guys down and take them down.
Underrated line that no one
he's
says.
He's a high flyer of the highest magnitude.
But he's still a cruiserweight.
How about hypnosis?
How about Dean Malenko? I was going to give him a title shot. He was a big man, wanted to injure me. Hey, come injure me now, you little punk. He's sitting at home with some kind of hokey injury. This is a real injury, Dean Malenko.
Dean Malenko.
This is a groin pull the likes you've never seen in your whole life.
Well, he right now is nursing a very bad sprained ankle. Yeah. And as far as that groin pull, you know people that compete in football and basketball, a lot of champions have to play hurt.
Oh, yeah. So you're saying I won't play hurt? I'll play hurt. I'm going to play hurt tonight. And I'm going to take this Booker T and show exactly what I've said a minute ago. He doesn't deserve a title shot. And Ric Flair, you go ahead and bring up your grudge. You got some kind of a grudge on me. You can try to force me into situations. You're going to put me in a title match with whomever you want, whenever you want.
Whomever
you
want.
That's fine, Ric Flair. That's fine, because you know why you're jealous of me? It's because I beat you. I beat you the day I came in, and I beat you every time I ever stepped in the ring with you, and you just got a grudge against me. That's all.
Make no mistake about it. On February the 21st,
am I right?
In Oakland,
yeah, I'm right.
You're going to be facing somebody, and that U.S. title will be on the line, Mr. Hart.
Whatever.
Thank you very much. Tony, a man that's not too Whatever. Happy, at least about defending the United States title, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Great
back
promo.
You,
goddamn. Classic. Rainmaker shutting down this dude. This lizard or whatever the fuck.
Welcome
there you go,
back,
that's that.
Ajay. So good to see you again. Kahan chale gaye the?
Dekho. Mujhe bina kisi rukawat ke tumhari duniya se dur jaane do. Main tumse vaada karta hu. Na tumhe koi nuksan pahunchega, na mujhe. Jaanti ho? Mere upar 18 khoon ka ilzam lagaya gaya hai.
Yeah, I try to have that same vibe that Brett had when I have a job. Which is probably why I don't have a job right now.
कितना बड़ा बोझ हमारे अजय के कंधों पर डाल दिया बेचारा कितने दर्द में जी रहा होगा ये
और वो भी तुम्हारे होते हुए
डैन. If you're just joining us, this is from a Bollywood film that had Crush and the fake Undertaker in it. Crush is dead. The fake Undertaker still running wild.
Undertaker को देखा है ना? इसके जिस्म पर बड़े से बड़ा जख्म लग जाए, पर दर्द नहीं होता है. सब डैन का कमाल है. जिस्म की सारे नसों का ताना बाना इसे पता है. अंडरटेकर जिंदा तो है, पर दर्द का एहसास मर चुका है. डैन, अब तुम और अंडरटेकर दोनों मिलकर हमारे अजय के हर दर्द को मिटा दो.
Ooh, Undertaker's not done. So they fled the cops when Undertaker was beating that one guy bloody. And now he's got a friend, this swole gentleman. Big kick. Ooh, choke slam on the bar. Ooh, kick to the gut, double team. The giant swing. Drops an elbow on the dance floor. Undertaker and his buddy. Ooh.
क्यों? सुन ली मौत की दस्तक. डरो मत. मौत भी तुमको तभी आएगी जब माया जाएगी.
Okada, kore.
Okada-san, oi!
Orito shoubu shiro.
Okada! Matasetana.
Oh, he's got Okada dash. So this is the card game that that cartoon is based on.
I don't remember what it's called. Called Buddy Fight.
Together at last, Kazuchika Okada and Mila Jovovich. Two of the best to ever do it. You said it, Dr. Liam. Oh, my God. I think that stuff's kicking in. Yeah, there's a dream match for no reason. Did Tony Khan book this commercial? Card, please. All right, and now the thrilling finale of Khiladiyon Ka Khiladi. Here he is, Undertaker, Three Stooges style. He's Mo.
उस दिन पुलिस की रेड की वजह से फाइट पूरी ना हो सकी. आज दोनों फाइटर मौजूद हैं.
We're going over. I think we have one match after this, the main event, but it's a rumble. But it's not long like a regular rumble, but it is main event.
हारने वाले की मौत से पहले उस पर आखिरी वार हम करेंगे, क्योंकि हमारे लिए तो दोनों ही गद्दार हैं.
No, मैं गद्दार नहीं हूँ. गद्दारी तो तुमने की है. तुम मुझे हरवाना चाहती थी पिछली फाइट में.
Dr. Shockmaster, yeah, I went through the movie and cut all the parts out, all the wrestling.
अगर मुझे मालूम होता कि इसने मेरे भाई को मारा है, तो इसे तो मैं उसी दिन खत्म कर देता, जिस दिन इसके साथी डैन को मैंने मारा था.
क्या? डैन की मौत धोखा?
Oof. So this is the hero of the movie right here. He's got a love scene. He's dancing. He's singing. I had to cut those, unfortunately. Oh, leg drop on Undertaker. He might be dead. He might have croaked.
Kill them.
Kill them. This is intense. Undertaker's up. I thought he was down. Oh, shit. This fucking rules. Clothesline. Choke slam. Oh, he's thinking of all the things the Undertaker has done. Undertaker down the ramp! Like Darby Allin! Oh shit, Tiger fucking style. He leaps at the Undertaker, knocking him down. There's that setup. Giving him the Iron Claw. Taker rolling around. This is my Iron Claw. Spinning back fist. Tip of the hat to Aja Kong. Oh, he's gripping the belly like Purple Haze. Taker. King Don looking real pissed.
My buggy.
He's got Taker up. He's eyeing those big fangs. Oh, shit. Wow. So he killed him. He killed the Undertaker. The Undertaker was impaled on those fangs, and that's the last we see of the Undertaker in Khiladiyon Ka Khiladi. And now, folks, our main event, our last Rumble ripoff for 2024. Thanks for sticking with me. 3 weeks of this. We are back to DDT. I can't believe it. Wanted more variety, but DDT is calling me like a siren song. Back to DDT, back to the Weapons Rumble, but this time it's from 2018 and it's Mao versus Shinshiro Takagi.
There's power! Harder! Harder!
Oh shit. Greetings! Did you happen to lose a silver or gold hammer?
No, I only dropped normal hammer.
For your honesty, I shall give you a gift.
Gift?
100 cans.
Whoa.
Thank you, reliable arbiter.
Hammer.
Oh.
Take these two.
Keep the gimbal.
Lots of gifts for
you. So Mao's got three hammers coming into this weapons rumble and a bag of cans. That might come up. Age difference. 27-year age difference. Shinshiro Takagi versus Mao. The Weapons Rumble. It was a hit last week. Now we're back. The first time a wrestler has been rewarded for honesty.
一定時間ごとに交互に入場してくるウェポンランブルルールで行います
なおこの試合に限りましてレフリーが独自に決めた場合よりすべての反則行為が認められます。大会日本の大事な試合、ソスバレ27歳代表の役者と48歳とその選手21歳による地上を表す放送劇最終決着ウェポンランブルシングルマッチ30分一本勝負を行います。
Here he is, the boss, the battling boss. The glass breaks. When the glass breaks, you know who's coming out. Making his second appearance of the night. We saw him in the Aja Kong Rumble. I can't believe we did three Rumbles 2 weeks in a row. No wonder we're going overtime. Last week's show is right on the money, though, right on time. This one I'm going to be docked. When I go over 2 hours, I have to pay Twitch $5 a minute that I go over. So I'm in trouble.
まあそれもそのはず、高地三四郎その魔王に何度となくひどい目に遭い、2回ほど車にひかれております。今日こそこの両国の地で、しかも自分にとって経験豊富なルールであるこのウェポンランブルで。
And this is a good time to remind you, if you're watching this, please subscribe on either YouTube or Twitch, or follow my Instagram. But it wants you to keep in touch. Keep in touch. If you're enjoying this, I do it every Thursday night live on Twitch. Now here comes Mao Hammerman, straight up, three hammers, the trifecta of hammers. Van Hammer himself doesn't have this many hammers in his home. Big Hammer from American Pro Wrestling blushes when he sees this. Look at Mao, Moonlight Express, getting buried under all the crepe paper streamers. What I was looking for. All right. Our main event. Our final Rumble ripoff. After seeing how a weapons rumble worked last week, I am so excited to watch this. I hope you are too. Hammer duel. Ooh, throws it down. Lock up. Takagi into the ropes. Shoulder block sends Mao down. Mao tries to trip. Leapfrog. Beautiful drop kip. Kip up. The younger man standing tall. Ask for the big hammer, the long hammer. Ooh, hammer to the head. Clubbing blows to the back, putting the boots to him. It's time for our first weapons rumble entrant. Number one. Dresser. We saw a file cabinet. No whammies, no whammies. Stop! Dresser! Now we saw a file cabinet be used in the, I'm gonna say it was the first weapons rumble, it was at least the first one we watched, And two mummies popped out. I don't think any mummies are coming out of here. The dresser of doom, you said it. Now that's a... reverses. Ooh, stops before he hits it. Oh, hits hard, the drawers! Now that's an IKEA. That's an IKEA. The five drawers are a little bit more than the four drawers. Takagi looking to, foot to the dresser. Here comes the next weapon in this weapons rumble. What is this? It's wrapped in barbed wire. It's some that children's toy. I think you sit on that and hop, right? Sit on this and hop, I believe, is said in a 90s movie. The barbed wire wrapped children's toy. Mao backflips out. The barbed wire baby scooter. Oh, take a seat. Barbed wire right in the asshole. Mao, opening up the drawers. What's in there? Rifling through the drawers. Who is he? Polly Walnuts? I can't tell what those are. Still can't tell. You can get close as hell, and I don't know what that is. I thought they were jello shots. Now they look like vibrators or vapes. Glow sticks. He's playing Finders Keepers. Can you imagine if someone had a match in the old Finders Keepers set? That'd be the shit. Mao is completely destroying this thing. Scoop and a slam all in the garbage that is coming from the drawers. Quick to get rid of that barbed wire scooter. Next weapon already from Mao's camp. Hitting them with the glow sticks. Here we go, cans. We're looking at about $2.55 worth of cans right there. Yeah. Ooh. I need to hand out awards at the end of the show. Because if there was an award for making me laugh, everybody would get it. But Brian has been making me laugh since the pre-show. Oh, on the cans. Covering them in cans. Rob Van Dam like moonsault, two count only on Takagi. What's in the box? It's an NWA CD. Oh! It's NWA's greatest hits. They joined Columbia House. They got too many. They got 12 for a penny. Oh, buried under CDs. I know that pain well. I used to work at the Virgin Megastore. Slam on the CD singles. Takagi going for a pin. Two! And the trash goes flying with the kick out. Why not? Time for another weapon. I know this music. Could it be? Oh my! That's my Michael Cole. He didn't know. Tensuke! This guy fucking rules. Once again, people are weapons. People count as weapons. This guy's good. I think it is a fake US title. I didn't even get that. That's perfect. So that's what was happening in 2018. Oh, Nakamura tripped over the... He tripped over the drawers. All right. Now here's a weapon. Takagi dancing. Dance break. Feather boa around the neck. Barefoot on the shoulder. Some people pay for this. Scooping a slam, Mao is down. Takagi going for the pin, his friend helping out. Nakamura is in there to stop it. There goes Nakamura. Ineffectual weapon. Tries to give him the US belt. Beautiful. I am never disappointed when we watch DDT on this show. Ever. Ever! Mao being walked. Being walked like a damn dog once again. Some people pay for that. Next up. Ooh, what is this weapon? Oh, it's a cot. It's a cot. She's got to be a dominatrix. Making the bed. There you go. That's our weapon. Takagi setting up suplex. Ooh, Mao fighting it. He don't want to hit that bed. There ain't no mattress on it. Nakamura! Ooh, Takagi hit his head on the boards. The bed went flying. The bed went flying off like the Chainsaw Charlie and Cactus. The folks are helping out. Now they can do their bump on the bed. Ooh, that's the sound of wood. Oh, God. Jesus. Nakamura's got the dominatrix. She's using her powers.
Kaori-san on stage.
So a reminder, the other DDT match we watched, I got off of a porno site. Not this one. Oh no! He blindly knocks out Nakamura. Bedtime for Chinsuke. Whoa. Now these two weapons are taking care of each other. There you go, they're gone. Thanks for playing two wonderful weapons. What's next? Or who's next? I don't know. Somebody went to the container store. Bed Bath and the Match Beyond. God damn. That rules. That would be a great match. I'm gonna bet that this is gonna be a bad bump. Ooh, plastic container to the head. Mao is stopped briefly. Oh Christ, I see what he's setting up and I don't like it. Super pumps! Oh my god! The plastic shatters! Another plastic container set up. The shards of the others are... Look at this... This ring looks like Dave Meltzer's office. Oh my god. All right, their ninth entrant, a Mao weapon. Hey, it's a vacuum cleaner. Looks like somebody's gonna be cleaning up this mess.
Ooh.
Kick and Takagi. They did. I almost had the rematch instead of this. I found the rematch first. And then I was like, let me go to the source. Yeah, this is where it gets scary. He's gonna vacuum seal him. Like he's leftovers. Flipping the bird. Yeah, this is some Charles Mason shit. This is unbelievable. He's vacuuming in him like his winter clothes being put away in the attic. Oh my god, hold your breath, brother. He's been vacuum sealed. Takagi struggling for breath. Mao, half a ring away. Top rope. Ooh, hey. Look at him buying time. Is that a phone number? The rematch was in Queens. Well, we might need to watch the rematch maybe on leftover night or something. I'll have a leftover night when spring comes. We'll have spring cleaning. We'll get rid of some gimmick stuff that's been hanging around. Needs the ref to help out. Answer the phone, Senshiro. I wish I know. I need to know Japanese. More of these plastic tubs. These plastic tubs are really coming in handy. They're a good weapon. Now up on the shoulders. Oh, shit, Spicoli driver through the plastic. Mao kicks out at two. Mao's on the shoulders, but they're about to be interrupted by the next weapon. This is a little different than the other weapons, the different intro. This one seems very scary. Oh, baby, we talked about him. We talked about him! He's here! He's here! The giant panda! A wise man once said, business is about to pick up, and baby, that's what I'm saying. Dr. Liam, with a little context, that's Andre the Giant's music. You? Giant Panda slowly making his way to the ring, Undertaker-esque in his entrance. Giant Panda, one of the best wrestlers that we watch on this show. Oh my god! Something has happened to Giant Panda. I think he's sick. I think he's sick. Headbutt, meeting of the minds. Big, I don't know if there's a big brain inside that panda, but there's a big, thick skull. There you go, we see the fan in his ass. Two fans, one's for each cheek. And they're leading the giant panda out like he's Chuck E. Cheese and needs help. Oh, that suit. Whoa. Oh, my God. Giant panda. He's ill. Mao thinking it's hammer time. We're having trouble with this panda. All hands on deck. Mao's very pleased. It takes a village to get that panda out of there. That might have been the final weapon of this match.
ました。
過ぎてますね。まあちょっと両国ということで張り切りすぎましたかね、パンダもね。
これ完全に今更地に戻ったんでですね、これ今からこの二人どうやってここを決着つけるのか
という
ところ
なんですよね。ここからがプロですね。
We all salute the giant panda, the Andre the giant panda, apparently. Back to trading blows in the center of the ring. This weapons rumble is nearing an end. Reversal by Takagi. Ooh! Now with a great kick. Duck. Clothesline, Takagi. Two! I think the panda was the final weapon. Ooh, Mao lands on his feet. Kick to the back of the head of Sanshiro. Kicks out at one. What in the world? How is he getting this? Plastic shattering over the skull of Sanshiro Takagi. More. Oh my god. No, thank you. Jesus. Ooh. That might be it. Takagi down. 2.9999. Back to how it all started. Back on these IKEA dresser drawers. Ooh. Ooh. Look at the drawers bent. 2. Oh my god, how in the world did Takagi kick out of that? I believe IKEA calls that a malm. Is that a malm? Is that a the seven drawer malm? 450 through the plastic onto the malm. Your winner of the DDT Weapons Rumble on our final Rumble ripoff of 2024. Wow, that was incredible. That ruled. That ruled. I think there's a little talking after this. I don't think we need to watch it. I'm going to do a little fast forward. He's got that phone. Wish we knew Japanese, folks. Who's he calling? I wish I knew. I bet it's great. See you next week, Crush Bra. Thank you. Next week, middle of winter gimmick show. All right, I don't think we're ever going to understand what's happening here. All right. And that's our show. That's our potluck. Fun one. Thank you, everybody, for sticking around and sticking with it. And for the positivity, the much-needed positivity. We got so many good possible names for this episode. And yeah, I appreciate everybody checking in, whether you're watching live or watching later on YouTube. We got, here's our titles, possible titles that I wrote down. We got Bollywood, Machio, very specific fetish, don't listen to me, shout out to Buckethead, take them to the big and tall shop, other exciting matches, jam up guys, and this guy's a serious professional. Those are the ones I wrote down. One of those will be the title of this episode. If any of them are calling out to you, tell me in the chat, because I'm easily swayed. Easily swayed. That's my rap name. Okay, thank you, everybody. This was a damn blast. Rumble Ripoffs riding into the sunset for another year. RIP Ice Train. Will we see some Ice Train next week in our middle of winter gimmick show? Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I got some Ice Train. I got some Ice Train sent to me, and it, you know, we'll see you next week. And I'll see you next week. Thank you so much for watching the show. And, yeah, of course we're going to have Glacier. Send stuff to me. Always open for submissions. Please subscribe, or if you're a weirdo, subscribe, please. Thanks, everybody. Have a good night. Have a good weekend. And have a good everything.